Finding probabilities using the normal table. For example, Ms. Brown wanted to know if take-home tests would result in higher exam scores than traditional in-class tests. The test scores resulted in a mean of 81 and a standard deviation of 6.02. What is the probability that a student scored higher than 87.02? For this example, it's asking us to find the probability that a student scored greater than an 87.02. So we're going to write this as the probability that X is greater than 87.02. To find the probability, we're going to first convert X to a z-score and then use the normal table to find the probabilities. So recall the z-score formula is the following. We have z is equal to x minus x bar over s. For this example, x is 87.02, the mean was 81, and the standard deviation was 6.02. This results in a z-score of 1. And so we've converted x to a z-score, and now we can find the probability that z is greater than 1. At this point, we're going to use the normal table to find the actual probability. Since we're trying to find the probability that z is greater than 1, again, we're going to use a table, so I'm going to draw this out for illustrative purposes. Again, I'm going to count 3 standard deviations to the right and then 3 standard deviations to the left. I'll label z being 1 on the scale, and this time I'll shade to the right because we're trying to find the probability that z is greater than this. So using the table, I go to z equaling 1. And its corresponding probability is 0.8413. However, recall that the table only tells you area to the left of a z-score. And so for this example, we're trying to find the probability that z is greater than 1, so this is area to the right. So I'm going to subtract this probability from 1, since the total area under the curve sums to 1. And so once I subtract, I obtain a probability of 0.1587. And so the probability that a student scored greater than 87.02 is 0.1587.